base of most host group among all double Benianis. Of course, they are the base of most, and we only consider insects. But we should only consider insects because the few known insect hosts are very probably the results of occasional host shift events in a given microhabitat, that is, they show ecological specificity. For example, last year we published a species called Rinkia basmani, thought to be a specialist parasite of ants, and we have found this parasite on mites living inside the colonies of ants. So they share the same microhabitat and they share the same parasite. The cockroaches themselves are only infected by three genera: Herpomyces, Labobenia, and Rickia. But the latter two have a very broad host specificity, spanning across insect orders. And again, these found on cockroaches are the result of probable host shifts, while Herpomyces is only known from cockroaches. The genus Herpomyces has about 25 described species, and they are classified in the Herpomycetaceae family. They are the only genus in the family. They are only found on cockroaches and mostly on the Antennae. Based on their Perthesium morphology and Ascus development, they were given a suborder status. They show primitive characters, morphological characters. Their morphology is reminiscent of the Pyxidiophoralis, the related order. And interestingly, the first sequence data were only made available in 2015 by our groups. So because of the basal host and the primitive morphology, the genus Herpomyces may have a crucial role in understanding the evolution of the whole class. For example, it was proposed that the original infection of cockroaches may have happened as early as the Carboniferous, and Labobenias could be co-diversifying with the insect hosts ever since. But the study of their evolution is hindered by their rarity and the lack of Herpomyces sequences in databases. There are also very few published Labobenia sequences, and what is published is only nucleoribosomal DNA. Furthermore, the Labobenianis are extremely rare in the fossil record. So our groups have independently collected and sequenced several genera of Labobenianis, including several species of Herpomyces from Central Europe and from North America. And we were very interested in the phylogeny of the class and whether there are signs of co-phylogenesis with the host and the parasite. So we were able to construct a phylogenetic tree for the class Labobenia-Mycetes, and it became apparent that the genus Herpomyces is forming a different clade, different from the Pyxidiophoralis order and different from the Labobenialis sensu stricto. So it may be elevated to the level of a new order. When we look at the different hosts for the different clades, it is apparent that the Labobenialis sensu stricto does not show a very high degree of co-diversification with the insects. For example, we have beetles on the Labobenialis tree as hosts here, here, and here on different clades. And we have Heteroptera, different bugs as hosts in this clade and in this clade. So there is no sign of strict co-diversification between the hosts and the parasites. When we looked at our samples of Herpomyces from Central Europe, we have found a potential new species. This one from the Turkestan cockroach, which is the Schalfrotella lateralis. And morphologically, it is very close to the species Herpomyces stylopyge, known from Dacta orientalis, the oriental cockroach. And this Labobenia species, this Herpomyces species, is found all over the world. So our sample was morphologically very close to it, but we were not sure if it is a new species or just a
Apuntoneados. Where are they in the Ascomycota tree?
Well, they are close to Sordario mycetes, and well, their phylogeny is only based on nuclear ribosomal DNA, so it is not absolutely sure where they are placed on the tree of the Ascomycota. It would be very good to have some nuclear genes for proteins, but so far we have none.
And are you planning single cell sequencing since the biomass, the tissue?
Yes, their biomass is